Hello guys, welcome to another session of Advanced Programming with Python. In this session, I will show you how you can create a project in PyCharm and how you can set the interpreter of PyCharm. So let's start, and in this session we will make a Hello World project where we will print some sentences or something. So let's start. And okay, so let's open the PyCharm. I have opened it, and here you can see four different tabs. One is the project, another one is the customize, and third is the plugin, and then learn PyCharm. So there are different plugins. If you want to install any kind of plugin, you can just go, you can search it and you can install it. You can also see what plugins are already installed. So these are the plugins which are already installed. You can also disable them if you want. So in customize, you can set the theme of PyCharm according to your choice. It's up to you. You can also set the font. I have set it font 14, but let's make it 16 so you can see it easily. Now let's go and make a new project. For to start a new project, you can see three tabs here. One is the new project, another one is the open, and third one is get from VCS. So the recently made projects are listed here. You can create a new project by clicking new project button. Here you will define the project name. For example, let's make Hello World project. Then you can select the new environment, what type of environment you want. If you have set up different environments, environments are actually the interpreter where you have installed different set of libraries, and then you can easily use that environment in another project, and then in another project you don't have to install the libraries again and again. So I have three environments. One is the virtual EVM, another one is pipe environment, and third is the Conda environment, which I have installed Anaconda, so that's why I have also Conda environment. So I am selecting virtual environment. In the virtual environment, I am just giving the name. If you want, you can change it. And then you have to select the base interpreter. So I have selected Python 3.7. If you have another Python, you can select that another one. You can see I have two Python environments interpreter. So I am selecting 3.7. If you want to inherit some global site packages, you can click here, or if you don't want, you can just create it. So here comes the first program. It's a sample code which Python PyCharm has already written it for you. Just as an example, you can delete it and start from the fresh. Here you can see that there is a hash and then a line is written. Actually, this is the commenting in Python. This is how you can do the commenting in Python. So I am gonna change this. I am writing this is a Hello World program. First program in Python. My first program in Python. Okay, so how we can print the things on screen is just a simple command which is actually print, and then Hello world, this is advanced programming course. So as you have seen in Java and in other languages that you have to terminate every statement, every line with some terminator, but here you don't have to terminate, you don't have to put any semicolon or something. In Python is the simple language, so you just have to write the line and then you don't have to terminate it. If you press enter, it will go automatically to the next line. It means there's another line starting, the new code is starting from here, another line of the code is starting, so the interpreter understands it automatically. So now you can go to run and you can run main. You can also click shift F10 if you want to run the program. So here you can see that the process finished with exit code 0. Exit code 0 means it successfully finished. And you can see here that it has printed hello world, this is advanced programming course. So if you want to print another line, you can just start from new line. Hooray! We made our first program in Python. Okay, so you can run it with Shift F10. But I'm gonna run it from here, so you can see that it's printing the lines which you are writing in single colons. So what if we write it in double colons? This line is written in double colons. Okay, go and run the program. So you can see that you can write the string inside the double colon or inside the single colon. It will print both lines. So same as if you want a new line, you can just type backslash n and this is the new line. And you can see here that it's printing, this is the new line in another line, so you don't have to write all the things in every time in new print statement. You can just type backslash n and you can write it. So this is your first program, hello world. Now let's go and see if what other things Python gives us. So for example, if you go to the settings, in the settings you are also seeing the appearance. These are some different settings. If you want to see this, you can set the font style and you can also set the size of the font, and then again the theme you can change it from here. There are menus and tools, you can arrange it by your convenience. Then there is some system settings. These things we will turn, I will give you some details about these things in coming lectures. So skip all of these things. Let's go to plugins. I have already told you what plugins are. Okay. So let's go to Project Hello World. In the Project Hello World, you can see here there is an interpreter. Python interpreter. You can change the interpreter from here also. If you have installed another interpreter, it can come. If you don't, you can add another interpreter from here. Okay, so you are seeing different interpreters installed on my system. Okay, for example, in the Conda environment, you can see I have Python 3.9 installed also. So if I want to use Python 3.9, I can just select this Conda environment and then I can choose my Python version. Another thing is you can see that there are different libraries installed. One is the pip one, another one is this setup tools, and another one is the vim. So these libraries are installed, and here it comes, it shows the latest version. So if you want to install another library, you can just click in plus icon here, and it will give you all the list of the libraries or packages which are available in Python. For example, if I want to install TensorFlow, so you can just write the tensor and it will give you the list of all the list of TensorFlow. So you can see here that there are different packages for the TensorFlow. You can install it as you want. For example, there is another library called scikit. So we will use these libraries in some image processing and some other techniques, and also in machine learning when we are implementing some other machine learning algorithms. We will use these libraries also. So you can see here that if you just type the library name or the package name, it will show you. Once you click it, and then you can just go down and you can click install package, and it will automatically install from the internet. It will download it and install it for you. So you don't have to worry, PyCharm is so easy. You just have to click the package name and it will download it and it will install it for you automatically. So that's it. I hope you found it easy, the setting up a new project and then writing a simple hello world program. That's it for this session. If you have any questions, you can ask me by email, obviously.